You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Tuesday, October 19th, 2021. Today is also the feast day of St. Isaac Jacques. St. Isaac Jacques was a Catholic missionary who left Europe and came to what is now Canada to evangelize the native peoples there. He gave his whole self to this work, and unfortunately, he, in his lifetime, was not very successful. He ended up dying a martyr at the hands of the people he was trying to evangelize. However, the seeds of faith planted by St. Isaac and others did flourish. Years later, St. Kateri was born to this very same tribe, and she followed Christ boldly because of the brave example of missionaries and martyrs like St. Isaac Jacques before her. Now, today you'll be hearing from Anthony D'Ambrosio once again about parables, the kingdom of heaven, and true treasure. Enjoy.
Guys, I'm back. It's Anthony D'Ambrosio here, and I'm so excited to be back to talk about the kingdom of heaven again with you today. Yesterday, we talked about the parable of the treasure buried in the field, and we talked about how the kingdom of heaven is like that buried treasure. The kingdom of heaven is the most perfect country that we could ever imagine. And by being friends with Jesus, we get to live in that country wherever we go. Even if we're living in a country like the US, where there's trouble and there's fighting and sadness or boredom, instead of being sad or angry or bored like other people around us, we can bring heaven with us to them wherever we go and make every place a little more like heaven. That sounds pretty cool, right? Right. But I said there was a catch. Let's look at the parable again. Jesus said, "The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in a field, which a person finds and hides again, and out of joy goes and sells all that he has and buys that field." So Jesus is saying, to get to heaven and to bring heaven with you wherever you go, you have to make a choice. That's why the person had to go and sell all that he has to buy the field. So what kind of choice is Jesus talking about? Well, what he's saying is that you have to make space in your life for the kingdom of heaven. Okay, what do I mean? Close your eyes and imagine something for a minute. Imagine that you're at school and you've heard that a king of some ancient, cool country has decided to send his kids to your school. Let's say he's like the king of Byzantium or something. So it's the talk of the school. Everyone's talking about it. Everybody wants to know who they are, and they're whispering, trying to figure out who they are so they can be friends with them. And you wonder what they're like. So you go to class, and it turns out that they're in your class. And when you meet them, you know, because they are the most beautiful, coolest people you have ever met. And it turns out they want to be friends with you. So one day, they say, "Hey, we want to come over to your house for a sleepover." So you say, "Great, let's do it." But then you remember that your house is a mess. You have toys everywhere covering the floor. You have old stuffed animals all over your bed. Your house is a mess. So what do? You clean up. You have to make room for them. So you pack all the stuff and you put it in boxes and give it to Goodwill or sell it so that you can have space to play with these new and important friends. That's how it is with Jesus. He's the son of the greatest king of the whole universe. He's even more important than the prince of Byzantium. I mean, he is the son of God, and he wants to come into your house and be your friend. And the amazing deal is, when you become friends with him, it means getting to be a part of his kingdom, the kingdom of heaven, that perfect country that I was talking about earlier. But you have to make room for him. So how do you make room in your life for the kingdom of heaven? Well, you know, when I really got to know Jesus, and I realized that relationship with him was worth more than anything else in the world, I knew that I couldn't have a relationship with Jesus and also care more about my stuff and my iPad and my room and my TV shows and what I wanted than him. When I started becoming friends with Jesus, I had to start cleaning out my life. I had to take time to stop and pray, to talk to him, to invite him into my day. Not just because my mom and dad told me to, but because I wanted to have him and his spirit and his power with me throughout my day. And I couldn't have Jesus beside me while I was thinking mean thoughts about my brothers and sisters or being angry with friends. I had to forgive. All of these things are ways of becoming more open to Jesus and to his kingdom in us. And when we do that, when we open up to him, it's like getting to have a secret buried treasure that we get to bring with us everywhere we go. All right, I can't wait to talk to you more tomorrow about this amazing parable. I'll see you soon. Bye.
That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God created you to be.
A big thank you to Anthony for hosting this week on Catholic Sprouts. And I would like to invite you to check out the new book that Anthony D'Ambrosio wrote and is launching this week. It is called Bickle and the Star Stone. It is a beautiful retelling of this same parable of the buried treasure. It is fun, colorful, great for the whole family. He wrote this book particularly for children ages 5 through 12. It is a beautiful chapter book that our family has already enjoyed, and it has a great, great message that we can all benefit from. To check out this book and be one of the first people to get your hands on it, simply follow the link that we're including in the notes for this podcast episode.
This show is a production of the Spoke Street Media Podcast Network. For more great podcasts, visit SpokeStreet.com.